Good evening.
Good evening.
Robert Reed Goodson, thank you. Robert Reed Goodson, Managing Artistic Director, and welcome to the second annual Risen Voices. This evening is to honor and celebrate Black excellence and Black history here within our community of Rocky Mountain. We're so delighted that you are with us this evening. If this is your second year joining us for this event, you'll notice behind us looks a little bit different. After our artists perform, they're going to go and grab the paint, and they're going to turn around and paint their emotions from their performance onto the canvas. And at the end, we're going to have this beautiful community piece of art that we will proudly display in our theater lobby. If you have never been to the Imperial Center, we invite you to check out the fantastic programs, science, classes, exhibits, and theater that are happening within our wonderful community of Rocky Mount. Coming up next, we do have 9 to 5, the musical, and that's March 1st through the 3rd and 8th through the 10th. And you can find your tickets online at imperialcenter.org. And also, you have, hopefully everyone got a season. And we hope that you take the time to get involved with your community, and may the arts be a blessing for us all. Thank you to our tech team, our vendors, and of course, the Imperial Center staff. So sit back, relax, fellowship, and enjoy tonight's performance of Risen Voices.
And it's on WNCR TV 41, 8 o'clock Saturday nights. But I'm an educator, and I was recently acknowledged by the city of Raleigh for educational rap. Now, a lot of people, rap, teaching, yeah. It really works. It helps you to remember, and that's why I started doing it. So the first poem that I'm going to do for you is called Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. And of course, you know, when I'm doing this, I'm playing music in the background. My coworker told me, Robert Frost is going to roll over in his grave and teaching his poem like this. So I always remember it. But the students will have to recite the poem along with recognizing imagery and couplets and stanza and all that good stuff. So it does work. And the second poem is going to be something I need for you all to join in with. It's called A Negro Love Song. It's written in dialect by Paul Lawrence Dunbar, who was recognized internationally for poetry. So when I point at you, you have to say, jump back, honey, jump back. In the rhythm of the music, we don't want the remix. Let me see if y'all can do it. I'll say something, okay. And a smile go flitting by.
Jump back, honey, jump back.
But y'all listen to the music now. Y'all can't mess up the flow. Okay. Here we go with Robert. DJ, kick it. Y'all think about the imagery in this poem. Give me a little more volume, please. Yeah. Remember, this is in the wintertime, in the woods, and nobody's out. These are, I think I know, his house is in the village though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near. Between the woods sit and miles to go before I sleep. And miles to go before I sleep. Come on. Now we're gonna move into a Negro love song. Y'all don't forget that when I point at you. Y'all just clap your hands, you know me, y'all come on. See my lady home last night. Held a hand and squeezed it tight.
Entitled, When I Say I Am a Christian. When I say I am a Christian, I'm not shouting, I'm clean living. I'm whispering, I was lost, now I'm found and forgiven. When I say I am a Christian, I don't speak of this with pride. I'm confessing that I stumble and need Christ to be my guide. When I say I am a Christian, I'm not trying to be strong. I'm professing I'm weak and need his strength to carry on. When I say I'm a Christian, I'm not bragging of success. I'm admitting I have failed and need God to clean up my mess. When I say I am a Christian, I'm not claiming to be perfect. My flaws are far too visible. But God believes I'm worth it. When I say I am a Christian, I still feel the sting of pain. I have my share of heartaches, so I call upon his name. When I say I am a Christian, I'm not holier than thou. I'm just a simple sinner who received God's good grace somehow. This one is entitled, Still I Rise. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Because I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springing high, still I'll rise. Do you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries? Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard, because I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness. But still, like air, I'll rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean, leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide, leaving behind nights of terror and fear. I rise into a daybreak that's wonderfully clear. I rise bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise. I rise. I rise.
Sliding down your back, diving into the ending of your arch, then falling asleep against your skin. Come get in this bed. As I use your ears as a treasure chest to store all the things I want to do to you, which catches a glance at your cheek inflating like a balloon at a child's birthday party, which is being accompanied by your body pushing back up against me, as if it's standing up for itself for the first time. Come get in this bed, as we know exactly what each other is thinking without even sharing the details, all because our fingertips are giving away our secret intent. Come get in this bed and allow us to get lost under the sheets, pretending we in this cave and my haven is finding you. Come get in this bed and let me turn you over. Gently caress your face as my muscle memories store the design of your structure in the spaces between my fingertips. Come get in this bed and allow your body to speak what your mouth won't declare. Speaking truth, your eyes agree to. Come get in this bed where your heart race can relate to a horse race after the gun has been shot. Come get in this bed and allow me to treat you like finger food. Allow me to take small pieces of you to hold me over into the main course. Come get in this bed and stay. Just lay lazy in your ever-changing thoughts while I hold you to remind you I'm constant, silent, unmoving. And the only other thing that will be changing are these positions your body will get familiar to. Come get in this bed. I have another piece. By the way, these poems are written by me, Sylvia Turner. They are in my book. Hopefully y'all can go get your gun. The name of this poem is called Learning. I'm learning that I must pray for more patience with her. I'm learning that she's used to guys not going places with her. I'm learning that her love language is me simply holding her hand. I'm learning she reassures herself by constantly calling me her me. I'm learning that everything I am giving, she never received before. I'm learning that with every confrontation she makes her way to the door, I'm learning that she'd rather stay in her head for comfortability. I'm learning that her constantly leaving is the only form of consistency. I'm learning that even through the humiliation, she still displays humility. I'm learning that every dumb decision she made kept others from viewing his stupidity. I'm learning that she is soft, but rough around the edges. So I hope to teach her that even a slight burnt bologna is good on bread with mayonnaise to bless it. I'm learning that she yells, but don't like to be yelled at. I'm learning that she despised arguing, so she always held back. I'm learning that she finally found a way to put all her emotions in one sentence. I'm learning now that I just need to listen without giving any objection. I'm learning that she craves reassurance, so I'll make sure she never has to guess. I'm learning that she likes to place her arms in the middle of my chest. I'm learning she likes to stay stuck under me. I'm learning that I must become her personal TP. I'm learning that the only time she shed a tear is cutting onions. I'm learning that in her mental space is a safe place for her to function. I'm learning that she's still learning me. I'm learning that I love you, leaving her lips sounds differently. I'm learning how to tell her I love her correctly. Thank you. Now, this is my last piece. I did this last year. I like the way the crowd reacts, so I'm gonna piggyback again. I was Lady J. So whenever you all hear me say love me, I want you all to say like it used to be. Love me.
Like it used to be.
Okay. Love me.
Like it used to be.
It used to be not even wanting to leave your home. Because you know later on you'll be staying up late on the telephone with the one you cherish. Love me.
Like it used to be.
It used to be saying, I love you more. No, I love you more. Constantly. Even though actions may speak louder than words, they still want to hear verbally love me.
Like it used to be.
It used to be saying, I don't care if I'll be late for school. Because the person that's on the other end is swearing they'll be late with you too. Love me. It used to be writing X and O's in your notebook paper. No, you need to take notes, but that person's name just won't seem to escape you. Love me. It used to be holding hands throughout the hallway. Pushed up against the locker, showing affection, always love me. It used to be the feeling you get as you sit and watch the fireflies illuminate the night, trying to figure out the creator who created these creations due to its amazing sight, love me.
Like it used to be.
It used to be visiting your grandparents on your summer vacation, all because of the treats and gifts, or how refreshing that person's soul seemed to be like a glass of ice water, so you simply take sips, love me.
Like it used to be.
It used to be those if-yous your grandmama used to say, just so she can get her way, Like, baby, if you clean your plate, then I'll let you go outside. But baby, if you let me love you like love used to be, then you will see love in me would be so easy. Because I give you that used to be love, just so you can get used to be love. Play songs that never seem the end type love. Having so much to say, I just don't know where to begin type love. See, around this time, someone much older than me would say usually losing this type of love would be foolery. So I just sit back with my heart open while he's schooling me. Tell him he love is self-explanatory, it will prove to be. Well, I'm gonna prove that love is what you need from me. And I do mean need, like water, shelter, and food to eat. I'm gonna give you my heart for a bed for your love to sleep. And you can count on me instead of those sheep. Because with anybody else, love without me, like it used to be. Thank you.
Of her accomplishments with you tonight, and then read one of her poems. Born in 1915, she grew up in Chicago and was educated at Loyola University, Roosevelt College, Northwestern University, and YMC College. In 1945, she won second prize in the Poetry Workshop Award of the Midwestern's Winter's Conference at Northwestern University. She was the first African-American assistant editor at Poetry Magazine. As a member of the South Side Community Arts Center, she met with a group of writers that included Margaret Ross Burroughs and Gwendolyn Brooks. In 1946, she founded the Arts Association Associates as a way to gather and promote Chicago's Black writers and poets. She would frequently correspond and collaborate with Langston Hughes, Dudley Randall, Hoyt Fuller, as well as others involved in the cultural movement of the time. She joined the Baha'i Faith in the 60s, which she shared with poet Robert Hayden, who in the foreword of her poem, Through the Very Patterned Lace, published in the October 1962 issue of the Journal of Negro History, referred to her as a fellow Baha'i. She was a touring poet sponsored by the Baha'i Teaching Committee and presented the spiritual orientation of the faith in many of her works. In 1968, Negro Digest acknowledged that her poetry long had reflected the now fashionable Black is Beautiful philosophy. Danner served as poet in residence at Wayne State University and Lemoyne Owen College. She received the John Hay Whitney Fellowship, the Harriet Tubman Award, the Poets in Concert Award, and the African Studies Association Award. Her poetry collections include To Flower, 1963, Poem Counter Poem with Dudley Randall, 1966, Iron Lace, 1968, a recording for the Black Forum series produced by Motown Records entitled Writers of the Revolution, Margaret Danner and Langston Hughes, 1970. And The Down of a Thistle, 1976. She died in Chicago in 1984. Her papers are currently held at the University of Chicago. And now, the elevator man adheres to form. Not really the elevator man at Newberry Library. I am reminded by the tan man who wings the elevator of Rococo art. His ways are undulating waves that shepherd and swing us, Cupid-like from floor to floor. He sweethearts us with polished pleasantries, gallantly flourishing us up and up. No casual highs from him. His greetings, Godspeedings, display his PhD aplomb. And I should feel like a cherubim, all fleur-de-lis and pastel shell-like. But instead, I vision other tan and deeper much than tan. Early Baroque-like men who seeing themselves still strutlessly groping, winding down subterranean grottos of injustice, down dark spirals, feel with such tortuous, smoked stone gray intensity that they exhale a hurricane of gargoyles, then reel into them. I see these others boggling in their misery and wish this elevator artisan would fill his flourishing form with warmth for them and turn his lettered zeal toward lifting them above their crippling storm.
Chicago Fire, and then later lost his other children, and his wife sent a telegram at one point to let him know that she was safe, and the telegram said, "Saved by grace alone," and it was years later, after all of the loss that he faced, that he wrote this song, starting with the words, "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul." Thank you. and this is Christy.
She's a DJ artist, and I'll get in more to that. Honey Redmond, more commonly known as Honey Dijon, is an American DJ, producer, electronic musician, and fashion icon. Renowned for not adhering to any particular genre, Honey Dijon is known for curating cross-genre sets. She has been a vocal advocate for trans rights and awareness, speaking from her experiences as a Black trans woman, DJ, and dance music based in New York City. Her 2022 album, Black Girl Magic, is a record dedicated to love. In her words, love of music, community, but most of all, the love of self. Being true to who you are in spite of everything else, and having the courage to love fearlessly. Love is the opening piece of the album, and it is spoken word poetry at its finest. This piece at its core is love, in all its strange, complex forms. They say love is love. He loves me platonically, yet romantically, I'm flawed. His love language is touch, and I need more. They say love is love. They say love, is the message that lives in our core. I dance for love, I work for love, I am love, mi amor. Agape, Eros, take my hand. Are you sure? No worries, duck and hide when you're by my side, my Wonder Twin, my best friend, my Phil, yet diverse. Extending into the metaverse, love was never meant to hurt. Love is love. Love is a state of mind. What I give is what I get. What I think, I attract. So I think of you, my love. A crush, a mysterious prince or princess, you are a whisper upon my full lips. Non-binary, legendary, your twist is my title for love. I flight or I take flight. If you're in love with her, right? I love in a way most ain't ready for. You breathe out, I breathe in, you breathe in, life begins. Now don't get it twisted. I love me some me. I ain't gonna find it. What was the lesson well learned? Scars once earned, now fuel for the only well deserved. They say love is love. Love is an energy, 528 HZ frequency vibrating through me. Loving you is easy. The ultimate test is to love thy enemy, and I love you all. Watch me work. This love is the reason my head is held high. Help me survive, so I let go. My love has no pride. They say love is love.
Thank you. today I'll be performing a poem that I wrote. It's basically my take on rising voices coming from the older male myself. I hope it connects to you as it connected with me. This poem is titled Random Thoughts by Evanson. I often find myself in my own mind, never knowing the next thought that falls behind. They can either be happy and sad, confusing or bad. They come into my mind daily, and I always find myself wondering why. Is there a reason behind it? What am I trying to testify? Even in this poem, I repeat this terrible pattern. Or do I? Is it terrible to speak our minds at a certain time? Or stand there quietly like a mime? I truly believe our voices should be heard. We should be able to use our words and not live in fear of them being stomped on or slurred. I want to encourage you all to be true to yourselves and stand tall. I leave you with this one last random thought. Is water wet? I wonder how long this question will hold.
Yeah. goodness. And I'm no Cedric Turner or Lady J and the rest of you, because y'all been coming to play. But I'm going to say my little original poem and get on out y'all way. It's entitled Me. Tell me what you see, a statuous woman before thee. I invite you to read each page of my book to discover me. Look into my eyes as the window into my soul to find secrets that have never been told. Me. Listen to my voice at times soft and sweet. Speak of my ancestral stories of days of old and being meek, me. Fill my heart lined with gold, shining bright like a diamond. It cares and always gives without being told, me. Learning my character is one to behold, making you laugh and cooking from my soul. A few of the things about me. Encountering my exterior will make one say, damn, she looks mean and I'm feeling some type of way. Please don't convey the words that are spoken make me true. You never know what a person has gone through. Once again, I invite you to all the wonders of me. Full of knowledge and have traveled the world, I always look for new challenges to admire like pearls. Never limit the things that can be achieved. Live life happy as you please. Trust and believe me. I will phenomenally be me. Before I leave, I have one question to ask. Who did you see? You or me?
But just bear with me. Act like y'all know that I ain't messed up. Because I wrote, so you don't know what I'm supposed to be saying. And then secondly, I'm going to do a poem, if I can see this, by Maya Angelou. Okay. All right, let's see. This poem is entitled, what else? Off the back of my friend, I am Yolanda. Many people want to know my identity because I'm much more than Miss Femininity. I speak boldly, but yet I remain a mystery. People struggle because they can't know my history. I bear testimonies of right and wrong, but through it all, I remain strong. I'm independent, I'm smart. I am thankful for God and all the things that He has brought me through. Listen, my Creator keeps me humble, but even more so, He upholds my stumble. Is that enough for you to know me, or must you try to alter my destiny? My destination is so solid that only God can change its formation. That's it, y'all. My memory didn't serve me real well, but it's okay. And the next one is, I gotta get off with this one. These lights are chilling. I won't read the whole thing because I know you guys, we gotta go. Y'all, you get old. You might stay out like we used to, right? But this is the title, one I love dearly, you guys. Phenomenal Woman. Okay then. Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute, that's false, or built to suit a full fashion model size. But when I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the spans of my hips, the stride of my steps, the cut of my lips. I am a woman, phenomenal, phenomenal woman, that's me. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honeybees, I say, it's the fire in my eyes and the swing in my waist and the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenal woman, that's me. Men themselves, I'm gonna have to read this whole thing, have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch. My inner mystery, when I try to show them, they say they still can't see, I say. It's the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the rise of my breast, the grace of my style. I am a woman, phenomenally phenomenal woman, that's me. Now you understand just why my head's not towed. I don't shout or jump around, unless I'm in church, or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing it all to make you proud, I say, it's the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palm of my hand, the knee of my chair, because I'm a woman, phenomenally phenomenal woman, that's me. Thank you.
Things and useless information seems to be one, and other stuff I can't say front of young children. But I'm a teacher. I was a law enforcement officer for over 20 years, and I'm a teacher now. And this month is one of the most exciting months for me in teaching, because my classes do not understand the impact the African American community has made in law enforcement. They never see that result, that end result, because those people have been forgotten about or been pushed to the side to promote other things against things instead of showing how they supported it. And as I was sitting there listening to all these things, I wanted to bring up someone that everybody has normally forgotten. And he lived from, and I normally have a presentation and we sit here for an hour, but I'll make it short. Samuel J. Battle. I love that name. Battle. Because he battled to be the first New York police officer. Okay? And everybody always thinks about people who make it great or make it grand, or they do something big and all shocking and catch the worst person. They don't remember the people that broke the ground against all the odds of people that never provided them with opportunity. And he battled for his chance to see that justice was served equally in the New York Police Department. He lived January 16, 1883 to August 7, 1966. And he was sworn in on June 28th. I can kind of remember that date because that's around all my kids' birthday. And again, useless information that I put together. But June 28th, 1911. How many even knew that African American men were making steps that grand? And we put them to the side. That's why I love teaching. I get to bring up things like this, and I get to shove it down my kids' throat whether they want it or not. And it shows them that normal people against the odds can make grand steps to change everything. So I say that this has been such a wonderful experience to me. I wish I would have known ahead of time so I could have forced some of my students to come. But when you leave, be a battle out there. To take those steps, to make those changes for all the things that we know are good, just like Samuel Battle did all the way back in 1911. Wow. Thank y'all so much.
Oh. my cousin a lot, so. Whatever. Do people take you through change? Do they make you feel bad about yourself? When you're only trying to do the best you can.
Thank y'all.
They wonder who you think you are, because you don't live in luxury, you don't travel fancy car. Yeah, you're happy because you are a child of God. So always remember you are somebody. Although they make you feel like you're nobody, 'cause if you believe in Jesus, you are somebody. Oh, this world can make you feel like nothing, because you don't live and act like they do. But it doesn't matter.
I'm glad I don't think like that anymore. I look in the mirror and see a person I adore.